died of a heart attack after saving her from the same fate. But which ones are real and which ones are fake? All will be revealed at the end of the show. In the meantime, watch our final story. We've named it Rediscovered. Edward Madeline may look like a sophomore, but he's a respected New York art critic whose word can make or break an artist's career.
As a matter of fact, nothing has to do with the power that I in the art world to recommend new artists to the general public.
There is no better example of this power than Edward's involvement with the reclusive painter, A.J. Knight. A.J.'s story starts in New York City, 1980.
I came across some of his works in an art gallery, and I thought that this was an artist of quality who really needed some encouragement. I thought he was very talented.
Despite being brilliant, A.J. also has a difficult time with the art world. It seems Edward is the only one who believes in him.
He didn't feel that his work was being appreciated quite in the way he wanted them to. And I think that he became very disillusioned.
In February of 1981, A.J.'s lack of success takes a devastating twist.
He tried to get to commit suicide at the point when he was just making his reputation.
But even from the grave, A.J. makes one final request.
I found a letter for something that I saw through the painting he had left for me to show them in about 20 years' time.
It's a bizarre request, but Edward respects A.J.'s wishes and puts the paintings into storage. 20 years later,
would have been the Queen that day.
Opens an exhibition of the late A.J. Knight paintings.
That could have a morbid interest that the general public takes particular care. And there's nothing more secure to the general public other than the value that attaches to the work of artists who's no longer going to produce painting.
To promote the event, Edward writes a critique in a popular newspaper.
The response was beyond many people's imagination during life. Worth its weight in gold.
Incredibly, all of the paintings sell. Edward nets over $1 million.
Well, I was very pleased that I had promoted the artist. He was a big talent.
Painting has been simply the art world.
The article was written, the television crews were there to record every statement that was made by anyone in attendance who appreciated or raved about the work.
But not everyone is buying the hype. Fledgling painter and writer Ulysses Guterres feels something to miss.
To me, it didn't seem to merit the boss he was getting. Looking at the work and seeing all the hoopla around it,
Ulysses begins to dig into the meteoric rise of the mysterious A.J. Knight.
They looked everywhere, really. I interviewed all kinds of people, and nobody seemed to know the actual person who played the painting. I think it's quite a lot of work. There's no records of this guy. There's just not.
Hello. Det är klättra på gardinen.
Ulysses runs another theory past Edward. Has this painter been using an alias to hide something? Could that be why he killed himself?
He actually started to laugh.
Ulysses doesn't get the joke, but suddenly everything starts to become clear.
My works are not serious works, they're art. one of my hobbies, which is the dabbling with paint. The reason I done it was to expose the falseness that prevails in the art world.
He was an emperor's new clothes type deal for him. He just wanted to make fun of the art world.
With Madeline's permission, Lizzie exposed the critic of the one created DJ Knight.
I wrote a big story about it. That's exactly what he wanted.
The news reverberates throughout the art world. A lot of people are very happy.
The show sold for over $1 million, so the collectors from both the worlds were a little bit angry. There were fraud charges brought against him, but he was able to prove that he was conceptual art. So he got off scot-free.
In the crazy buzz of the modern world, anything can be art, even hope. All you need to do is make them believe.
They were never able to prove that it was a fraud. That the whole activity was my artwork.
So did this art world hoax ring true? Or did we paint you an elaborate lie? It's time to reveal the truth about our three incredible stories. First up, it's a story of Karen Simmons, who kidnapped her own daughter in order to relive high school. But did it happen?
High school is a wild ride, but I think you want a better one. It's fake!
But something similar did happen in Wisconsin. In 2008, a 33-year-old woman attended cheerleading practice, and she dropped out for the school year. Next, it's the story of Joanne Olsen. Kids, from the heart attack, and we've got the same thing. But is it fact or fiction?